Hey fam, what's up, what's good? Well, this is a video I've been waiting a long time to do. I had planned it maybe a couple or a few months ago. And it's going to be kind of like some videos that went around maybe a few years ago about putting your problems out on Front Street, because I'm just going to lay out a whole bunch of realness, just raw, complete, total, utter truth. You know, regardless of how it makes me look or what people think, because, you know, what people think don't matter. It doesn't matter what druggies who snort Oxycontins up their nose think about me. So, anyway, this is basically a year in review and what's going on and everything. You know, the first half of the year, I did start off really good, really strong. You know, the first 6 months, cat hair, but, the first half of the year, I really was dedicated to, you know, losing weight and getting in shape and bettering my life, and I really got far. I lost about 45, 50 pounds, and I felt absolutely fucking great, but, come summertime, you know, halfway through the year, end of June into July, my grandmother started having some serious health problems. She went into the hospital for pneumonia, and then she got meningitis, and then she was just in the hospital for a long time, and they eventually found out she had colon cancer, so she had a colostomy done, which they're supposed to reverse in February, and she's been home since October because Medicare only pays for a certain amount of days in the hospital within a calendar year, so she has to be at home for the rest of the year until she can go have anything else done. And she's on chemo pills, which Medicare at least pays for that, because they're $2,000 for 2 weeks of pills. And just having to take care of her 24/7 and everything that's gone on in the second half of the year, it just became more and more stressful as time went on, and throughout, you know, late summer into the fall, I just fell out of taking care of myself because it's become my 100% complete duty to tend to her and not think of myself. So, yeah, I have fallen off of the path that I was on. I have, you know, gained weight back, and I feel like shit now. And on top of that, over the last couple of weeks, I've been having a lot of pain in the left side, and it's kind of like back in my early 20s, I used to have pain on the right side, and after a couple of years of complaining about it, my family eventually took me to the hospital, and my gallbladder had to come out. So I've been looking up online, you know, what it could possibly be, because, you know, back when I was 22 or 23, whenever it was that my gallbladder came out, back then they had a federal program where if you were low income, the hospital would write off the cost of your care because the federal government would pay for it. But now the hospitals don't participate in that anymore, so I'm completely on my own. I can't see a doctor now, so I'd just be left in the streets to die. And I started, you know, looking up, you know, what could be wrong, and found out that, you know, once you don't have a gallbladder, the next thing that you end up killing off is your pancreas. And what I gather is you can live without a pancreas, but there's only like two places in the U.S. that can safely remove a pancreas. And then you have to take insulin shots and tons of pills from then on for the rest of your life in order to live without a pancreas. And that's just not going to happen for me because I live here in bumfuck West Virginia, where they refuse to accept federal money to help poor people see a doctor. So No one's going to take care of me. No one's going to give me a prescription because they think I'm going to abuse it. And, yeah, I'm completely on my own. And so I'm going back on all the supplements that I started on at the beginning of the year. Plus, I've gotten a few more things. I still got one thing coming to me on the way through the mail. But for health reasons, I'm just forced. It's just do or die. I've got to get myself to a raw vegan diet, or at least, you know, come, you know, pretty damn close to that. You know, just raw fruit, raw vegetables, you know, nuts and seeds, and that's pretty much all I can safely eat, because anything else is gonna fucking kill me. And yeah, it really sucks because, you know, some people are just able to eat whatever the fuck they want for their whole life and have absolutely no ill effects. And then there's some people like me who's just have a genetic makeup that, you know, every, you know, normal food that normal people eat is bad for you and it's gonna hurt you. And I'm just not one of the lucky ones that gets to get away with doing whatever the fuck I want to do. So it's do or die now. There's no escaping it. There's no way around it. No ands, ifs, or buts. I have to fucking change, and I have been changing in the last few days. Yeah, I'm not really gonna be able to afford to keep up with a raw vegan diet exactly. I'm probably gonna have to go to, you know, the canned shit that we get from the food banks, and, you know, maybe living off of some stuff that's not that great, and which is why I looked more into other supplements, because, you know, food prices are really meant to keep us, you know, fat and sick and even kill us off, because, you know, a tiny little package like this that's like that thin and like that big of, you know, blueberries is like $4 or $5 depending on what store you go to, and yet, you know, you can get a burger and fries for that price. So, you know, what do poor people normally do? They get the cheap stuff. They get the ramen, they get the burgers, and they get the fries. You know, they get the pasta. They get what's cheap. You know, it's a lot more expensive to buy, you know, fresh fruit and fresh vegetables all the time. And right now we're okay because my grandmother's sister gave her some money for Christmas, so we've got fresh fruit and fresh vegetables in the house for, like, the first time in forever. I don't know how long we're going to be able to keep that up. So, I got a couple more supplements, and I'm going to show you all of the stuff that I got here. Yeah, I got a huge box. It's kind of overflowing. This is part of my, like, trans regimen. I haven't used all of this. I got this, like, towards the beginning of the year. Flaxseed oil. I'm taking that again. This is new. Pomegranate concentrate. The antioxidants are good for the pancreas and whatnot. And this shit is one of the ones I'm just going to take until it's gone. Because it really does nothing. Milk thistle. I bought that, you know, for my liver, but that is also what helps the pancreas, so I'm back on that. I have these thyroid support, which I don't think these things worked at all, so I'm only taking them until they're gone, and I've got 2 left. There were 5 left when I started this 3 days ago. Just more tribulus, B6, more tribulus, magnesium with zinc, and that's about it. And then I've got a pancreas support supplement on the way. And oh yeah, I'm missing this one that I just got. It says liver cleanse, but when I was looking for stuff for the pancreas, this thing came up as like the top search result, so I went ahead and got it because It's got some of the same stuff that's in the pancreas supplements, so I'm just going on all these supplements again. And what really sucks here is I don't and can't swallow pills. I just have this incredible gag reflex and such a fear of choking to where pills just don't go down. So when it comes to all of this stuff, a lot of it's powder, so all I have to do is open the capsule, dump the powder out. And then some of them are, you know, like gel caps, like, I'll show you, like this. So what I do is I just cut the tip off and squeeze the crap out of it, and, you know, these powders and concentrated shits really taste fucking horrible, and that's part of why I went off of doing it every day. Just too stressed out, and I really didn't get a chance to, you know, set aside even 2 minutes to myself to take care of myself. So I didn't have a chance to sit down and go through this long and disgusting process of getting these nasty tasting things down the hatch. And it is a long process because it's just nasty. So that's what I will be doing, and for those of you who still think I can't do it, well, fuck you, because it's do or die. Just like I said, it's do or die, and there's no way I can let myself down this time. You know, the only failure is not even trying at all, and this isn't even about trying right now. This is about fucking living. This has seriously got me scared, and yeah, I have to change or else, and that's all there is to it. Like I said, no ifs, ands, or buts. I have to this time. And just to talk a little bit about the whole end of the world 2012 thing, no, I did not actually believe that the world was going to explode or implode or be burned up by the sun or whatever. I was just have always been interested in it because of the ancient history aspect, because all my life I've been into the ancient Mayans and Incas and Aztecs, and all of that stuff has just really fascinated me for some reason. And it's pretty exciting to me that we live to see the end of their calendar, because, you know, this is something that's been around for 5,000 years, and we're here to see it. But I'm actually disappointed because it's pretty anticlimactic for, you know, nothing to happen at all. Because I wish there would be a change in thought. I wish there would be a transformation in the way people are in society. I wish people would wake up and be more compassionate to others, and that things would change for the better. But I fear, you know, it's just another day, and we're just gonna keep on going down the same road to hell that we've been on. And it's actually depressing as fuck to think that, you know, this big day will come and go, and absolutely not a damn thing will change, and we're still gonna be going to shit as a society and as a world, just as usual, you know, business as usual. And that fucking sucks, because, you know, I really, you know, wanted a better future, and things are just shit in the world. People are going crazy. You know, all these shootings, not just the school shooting, but shootings at malls and everything else. I think there's probably going to be, you know, riots and shootings on the 21st with just, you know, people going apeshit crazy and whatnot. But I think that's all we've got to look forward to, is just more and more violence, more and more loss of freedoms, more and more control over our lives, and everything just going straight down the shitter. And yeah, it's fucking depressing. So, you know, what can we do? Well, so that's about it. That's where I stand. And yeah. So, peace out, fam. Whoop, whoop.